Oh, it's Wednesday, good brothers and good sisters. Time for a shave, day and a half or more so of growth, not quite two. Gonna have kind of a German-Italian shave. Phoenix Artists at Accoutrements, 11-235, Douglas's take on 4711, which is mostly a neroli, old bergamot, jazz, a few things. Classic scent from the 1700s. It's really nice, fresh. I just wanted a fresh, light, clean thing. Gonna chase it with the aftershave. Picked up the Eau de Cologne on a good deal from, I think it was fragrancenet.com. It's a tester bottle, but it's new, so. Stray Whisker After Balm. Your Tiege Hanley morning pairing of eye cream and a moisturizer with SPF 20. The Italian part of the shave is shaking it out here. Big Bruce brush, 26 mil, RazoRock. RazoRock baby smooth with a little bit of Russian thrown in with a new Ladas blade. Now I'm going to pause because I did not fill the sink yet with the water and I will be right back. Okay, it was twofold because I also forgot the Thayers in the fridge. Yeah, Steven and other gents, you're right. Need a mini fridge down here. I mean, I got two bins down here, so putting a mini fridge, I'd have to move one bin out and put it in the closet there or use my large bin that's in the closet, which is basically empty minus hardware at the moment. So, cold water in the sink, brush is wet, it's wet the face. Of course, I'm out of the shower, back from the gym already. This shirt used to be tight as hell even when I first got it. This is a Alamo City Pitbull Rescue and Rehab, a fundraiser shirt they did. As you know, I got a 9-year-old girlie. She's asleep over here, as a matter of fact, on the bed out of shot. Brindle Pit. So get lathered up here. Of course, it's PAA soap, so soap base always the same. As I mentioned before, I have to get the water level correct. Make sure it doesn't get gummy for me. It's just the soap formula. Every soap's a little different. You gotta hit it correct. But I wanted a fresh, clean, classic scent. It's bowling night. I need a rebound from a shoddy week or two after a really good week a couple weeks ago. So the scent is nice and strong on this soap. Well done, Douglas, Fran. Definitely goes with the cologne in particular. The aftershave is a little fresher and cleaner. The cologne has a little more heft. It doesn't last long. I mean, I just saw a guy. Funny as hell, I forgot his name. Definitely Italian by descent. Talking about how 4711 versus Tom Ford's Neroli something or other. I forgot the name of it and I don't really care. It's the same damn thing. So, okay, maybe Tom Ford's lasts longer, but you're paying out the wazoo for it. This strength off the, you know, lathered up. Off the puck, it's good. It's solid. It's a high mid. But the fragrance really kicked up once I lathered up. So my frag deliveries started to come in. The big part did. Now, today or tomorrow will be the granddaddy, and I'm looking forward to that. All right. Yeah, I dropped some coin, but the price I got, it was worth it. Why I'm using the baby smooth today is Jen asked me how I liked it. I've only done one full shave with it before. So I wanted to do a full shave on camera for him. But it lives up to its name. Super easy angle. Ladas blade is performing well in it. For those who don't know Ladas, it's the same company as Voshod and Rapira. Comes in this wrapper, super stainless. As far as I know, no coating, like no Teflon. I would say ceramic on the Voshod, it's Teflon, sorry. I think ceramic, if I'm not mistaken, or on a, it's like a weird ceramic blend on Derbies or Darbies. Huh, a little weeper there, kind of shocked. But I am making a classic mistake, I realized. A little too much pressure for no reason, I need to stop that. In my opinion, Ladas are underappreciated as a blade. Voshod's a great. I got in on them finally, you know. You've seen me use them fairly recently here and there. Oh. Speaking of other deliveries, I got some pole silvers coming. Since I only tried those earlier on in my experience, everyone still raves about them, I found a 100-pack free shipping on eBay for a great price. So I jumped in on that. I should have plenty of blades to last me forever. Monday night, I had kind of a, I wouldn't say a big dinner, but a bigger dinner, so I know I'm back over 230, but that's mostly food weight, and that's going to clear, obviously, because otherwise, I didn't cheat my diet, except for, I mean, it was a good dinner, but it weren't huge portions or anything, it was just a full meal with a very small dessert. So I probably went over my calorie count, but my metabolism's up, so that's good. Yeah, this soap, for the, I've seen people shave with it, but I haven't seen any videos on it. It's definitely a lovely cologne scent. This would be your spring, summer, but I just wanted fresh. It's warming up. It's near the end, getting near the end of February. So it's not going to be really colder anymore in Texas, at least South Central Texas, so. So, for me, your citrusy, acidic, higher alcohol versus powdery and musky, darker scents I like to wear in the summer. So anything that's Creed, Aventus, stuff like that. Well, it could still be powdery, but as long as it's on that citrus tip versus your darker, kind of heavier, muskier. You know, what's basically clean and fresh. That's what I like. Now, nights, depending, you know, wear something a little different. If I, like, for example, I love 1X during the day, but like 2X at night, like, oh yeah. Yeah, Double X by RazoRock. Love that scent. Figured I'd release that lather out of the brush now because it's not giving it up itself much, which is kind of disappointing. I see plenty of lather came out, say the least. So I don't know. Huh. Yeah, I'm doing something wrong here today. Ignored in and out of weepers. Might be. Might be rushing, my skin might not be, might be a dead blade, I don't know. But we are not going to overdo it today, because obviously we're having issues. This is not turning out to be the best. We're going to wrap up. Wow, I am just opened up all over. I think I'm going to junk this blade. Not amused with this, though. This Ladas is performance. I mean, I've used the other ones in the past, never had. Yeah, blade's tight. Never had this such issue. Huh. Wonder if it's not a good pairing in this razor. Never had that much weeper action with a Ladas. I've done plenty of shaves with them. So my best shaves have been before camera. That's why I bought a 100 pack. But I do need to clean up here a little, so let's take some off the puck here. Because this is just, maybe this razor isn't for me. You know, lather was fine. Oh well. Let's just chalk it up to, you know, maybe I'll revisit this blade in another razor. I think on Friday. But well, it's kind of Weeper City there. That's pretty shitty. And it closed up nicely. Probably would be better in my ATT or something. Yeah, well, it closed up nicely, so I don't know, but not the best shave. Color me unamused, kids. I'm gonna shave Thursday anyway, so that really doesn't matter. Cold Thayers. Excuse me. That stuff doesn't really have any lasting power, but it smells nice. Yeah, I don't. Right now, I just don't have any BS to talk about. I've kind of talked out a lot of it the last couple days. And a lot of it is, there's stuff I can react to. But I'm not looking at the news a lot. I'm catching enough of what I need from multiple sources to give me a balanced picture. And I hate to say that the media hasn't learned their lesson about biases once they've been exposed. But they're still chopping news and trying to make them look bad and make the president look, make themselves look good and make the president look bad. But, you know, the emperor has no clothes now, so. And I'm not necessarily one to be in agreement with anything all the time, Fox News or, you know, right-wing radio or so-called regular media nowadays. So, your mainstream. I mean, I really like to do my research and balance. But the more Trump calls him out, the more they go against him. And, you know, make themselves look foolish in the process. People aren't believing him anymore because they've been exposed. I mean, all that stuff they, people who used to work, you know, as for CNN, and then went back and worked for the Democrats and, you know, got Hillary the questions early and things like that. Everything's been exposed, but they don't want to deal with it. They don't want to admit to their own problems, which is really embarrassing. I mean, both sides have problems, believe me. All right, so we are done here today. I hope y'all have an excellent Wednesday, and I'll see you Friday for the next shave. Give my skin a break here, see what the world tells me. And Weeper's closed nicely, so that's good, but my skin, I can tell, will need the rest. So take care, see you Thursday, see you Friday, be safe. Congratulations, I forgot to say, it's the beginning to Stephen, the Care of the Suffolk Shaver. Congratulations on 500, my friend. Well deserved. You're a gentleman, a scholar, a fellow nerd. Love you, brother. I thank you for being one of my best good brothers out there. Hi to Chris, by the way. another cut above with Chris. My other good brother, David Munoz, Rich Hansen, the rest of you, Will Carter, Wisconsin Piper, Wolfpack, all a bunch of new subscribers lately. Thank you so much for watching. Love you. You know, thanks for coming and putting up with this idiot. And I know who I am. I'm an idiot. So I'm just having fun. Take it for what it is. See you later, folks. Have a great day. Bye.